Good morning to all. My name is P. Amshit Prasad. I am working as an assistant professor in St. Martin Engineering College in HNS department as a physics faculty. Today I will give the lecture on dielectric materials. Okay, the importance of dielectric materials is dielectrics are bound charges which possesses permanent electric dipole moment. Due to bond charges, electric dipole moment can be classified into the two type. First one is polar molecule and non-polar molecule. The importance of polar molecules and non-polar molecules is polar molecules having the permanent dipole moment with asymmetrical charge distribution. The examples of polar molecules is H2O. In non-polar molecules having the zero dipole moment, these materials are having the symmetric charge distribution. The examples of nonpolar molecules are alcohol and benzene. So dielectric materials which possesses bound charges but its configuration based on bound charges, it is having for non-metallic materials with a high specific resistance. Okay, now here I am considering the dielectric materials due to the complex permittivity is a function of real part as well as imaginary part. In this equation I am writing the complex dielectric permittivity is a function of the real part as well as imaginary part. The real part of the dielectric material is also called the dielectric constant. The imaginary part of dielectric material is also called the dielectric constant. The importance of the real part of dielectric material is it is a measure of the amount of energy from external electric field stored in a material. The imaginary part of dielectric material is also called the amount of energy lost from the material due to the external electric field. This is having for the polar material, this is having for the non-polar material. The non-polar material having for dielectric loss. For example, microwave oven. Okay, the importance of microwave oven is it works on the principle of dielectric heating. Suppose when an electromagnetic wave of frequency 2.5 GHz is passing through the polar material. Okay, the example of polar material is water molecule. Here the water molecule try to rotate from one equilibrium position to the another equilibrium position. So the rotational frequency of this water molecule is equal to the incoming frequency of the electromagnetic wave. So here the rotational dipole moment is responsible for the dielectric heating. This dielectric heating is comes under the microwave oven. So in the microwave oven, I am taking here one is the conventional cooking, another one is microwave cooking. I am taking two parameters here. One is the conventional cooking and microwave cooking. So the importance of conventional cooking versus microwave cooking is the conventional cooking will take the extra time. Microwave cooking is take the very less time to easily identify the material which one is heated first. So in conventional cooking we are having for the external source we required. In microwave cooking we are take the external parameter due to the incoming frequency. So in this concept I am representing here electric flux density in terms of dielectric material. So here electric flux density, flux means the number of lines per unit area. I am representing here electric flux density D equal to epsilon into E. So here the interaction of electrical energy with matter is determined by the electromagnetic properties of the material. So I am writing here electric flux density is directly proportional to the electric field strength. Okay, so the permittivity, the importance of this one is on a microscopic scale, on a microscopic scale under the steady state condition, these properties are conventionally described by the permittivity and permeability of the material. So here I am taking the permittivity equal to permittivity of the free space into relative permittivity. Okay, permittivity of the medium can be written as permittivity of the material into the free space, that is vacuum, into the relative permeability of the material. These three are the dielectric constant. So here the dielectric constant equal to permittivity of the medium divided by permittivity of the free space. Okay, this is called the dielectric constant, or we can call relative permittivity of dielectric constant. So it is the ratio of permittivity of the medium by permittivity of the free space. Based on this equation, I am representing here as the polarization, I am taking the polarization P as the polarization measures additional flux density as compared to the arising from the free space of the material, arising from the free space of the material. So here I am writing the equation D equal to epsilon naught E plus P. Okay, electric flux density equal to permittivity of the free space compared to the additional polarization process P. So already we know dielectric flux density D equal to E naught ER into E. So I am substituting this value in the above equation. E naught ER capital E equal to E naught E plus P. Taking E naught common, that is permittivity free space, minus 1 into E equal to P. Therefore P equal to permittivity of the free space, that is vacuum, into relative permittivity minus 1. So into E, this equation representing the dielectric material due to the polarization process. So here it is having for microscopic quantity, right? It is having for microscopic quantity. The importance of dielectric material is first characterization. What about its characterization? Here the characterization of dielectric material depends upon the frequency as a function of temperature. I am representing here the frequency as a function of temperature, or as a function of temperature at a given frequency. That's why I am writing here कॉम्प्लेक्स डाइइलेक्ट्रिक परमिटिविटी इक्वल टू रियल कांस्टेंट माइनस द इमेजिनरी कांस्टेंट. सो बेस्ड ऑन द इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स डेंसिटी एंड पोलराइजेशन प्रोसेस आई एम रिप्रेजेंटिंग द वन मोर इक्वेशन दैट इज पोलराइजेबिलिटी अल्फा. The polarizability alpha can be written as mu by E. So I am writing here mu equal to alpha into E. What is mu? Mu is called for induced dipole moment with respect to the electric field strength, that is capital E. So here if the induced dipole moment mu is increases, electric field strength is also increased. So induced dipole moment is directly proportional to the electric field strength. Electric field strength. After that, during the polarization process, I am representing the polarization factor P equal to N into mu. This P is called the polarization vector. The polarization vector is directly proportional to the induced dipole moment with respect to the n. N for the number of dipole moment per unit volume. N is called the number of dipole moments per unit volume. So based on the fundamental definitions of electric flux density and dielectric constant, polarization factor, polarizability and polarization vector P equal to N mu, I am defining the one more term that is called for the electric susceptibility. So electric susceptibility is based on the polarization vector P equal to electrical susceptibility into capital E. So electrical susceptibility can be written as E equal to P by E into dielectric constant, that is free space. Electrical susceptibility equal to polarization vector P by free space into the electric field strength. Already we know the polarization vector P equal to free space into the relative permittivity minus 1 into the electric field strength divided by permittivity of the free space into the electric field strength E. So cancel these two terms, we get susceptibility equal to dielectric constant minus 1. This equation represents the relationship between the electrical susceptibility versus the dielectric constant. So these are all the fundamental definitions regarding the dielectric materials. Now once again I am going to the next topic is why these dielectric materials are applicable to the solid materials and liquid materials. So there are number of techniques are available for the measuring the dielectric material based on the liquid sample. So I am taking here two techniques, one for the open-ended coaxial probe method, one more is the transmission line technique method, So first one, open-ended coaxial method. The open-ended coaxial method is applicable to the dielectric properties of the liquid sample. Now, transmission line method. The transmission line method is also applicable to the dielectric properties of the liquid material. The difference between the open-ended and transmission line technique is open-ended coaxial probe method is applicable to the very high range of frequencies. Its frequency range is nearly 20 megahertz to 20 gigahertz. Its frequency range is 20 megahertz to 20 gigahertz. Transmission line technique, it is very disadvantageous. It is operating at low frequency medium. Low frequency medium, its frequency range is less than 20 megahertz. Less than 20 megahertz. So here, the working principle of open-ended cloacal probe method is when an electromagnetic wave of some particular frequency is passing through the coaxial probe method, when an electromagnetic wave of some particular frequency is passing through the coaxial probe, what happens here? Some part of the wave is reflected and some part of the wave is transmitted. From the reflected signal, we can get the reflection coefficient of that sample. The reflection coefficient can be directly converted into the impedance. Directly converted into the impedance at that frequency, and that is related to the complex dielectric permittivity of the sample. Okay, here the reflection coefficient can be directly converted into the impedance at that frequency, and that is related to the complex dielectric permittivity of the sample. Here I am using the dielectric probe in three methods. First one is, I am using the dielectric probe with respect to the open position. Next one is, I am inserting dielectric probe into the water. Okay, open means it is air medium. The inserting the probe is in liquid medium. Its frequency range is 40 MHz to 20 GHz. At this range only we are getting for electric reflection coefficient. The reflection coefficient is denoted by this symbol. So the reflection coefficient equal to ZL minus Z naught divided by ZL plus Z naught. Here ZL is the load impedance, Z naught is the characteristic impedance. So here, based on the reflection coefficient sample, I am measuring here liquid sample related to the NDT technique. It is called for NDT. The meaning of NDT is non-destructive testing method. So NDT, the purpose of NDT is, it is a testing method or evaluation performed on any type of object means I am using here only for liquid sample. Okay, it is a testing method or evaluation performed on any type of object without changing or altering that on object to determine the presence of defects in the material. That's why the open-ended cloacal probe method is applicable to the non-destructive measurement of the liquid sample as well as bio-liquid sample. So this technique is applicable only for the high range of frequencies. So in this dielectric material, based on the polarizability values, we are having for different types of polarization process. The first one is electric polarization. Based on the types of polarization, we are having the four types. First one is ionic polarization, and second one is electric polarization. Third one is orientational polarization, and fourth one is phase charge polarization. So here, ionic polarization. The importance of ionic polarization is, especially in dielectric material, I am taking here one positive charge and one negative charge. So here, one positive charge and negative charge separated by some amount of distance d is called dipole. That is dipole. The dipole is placed in electric field, it acts like electric dipole. The same dipole is placed in magnetic field, it acts like magnetic dipole. Okay, I am writing the dipole moment P equal to 2aq. It is the product of the two charges, P equal to 2aq. Ionic polarization, I am taking NaC here. So in this one, Na is the positive charge and Cl is the negative charge. I am calculating here polarizability of ionic polarization equal to alpha I equal to E square by omega naught square into capital E divided into 1 by small m plus 1 by capital M. So here what is omega naught mean? Omega naught is the natural frequency of the ionic molecule having for positive charge and negative charge. 1 by m plus 1 by capital M is equal to the ionic polarization due to the negative charges and positive charges. Its relation is this equation is equal to the reduced mass of the system. Same like electric polarization, polarizability can be written as alpha equal to 4 pi epsilon naught into R cube into capital E. Here electric polarization, in the absence of electric field, as the atoms are moving in the random direction, once you apply the electric field, what happens? The unpolarized atom will changes to the polarized atom with different orientation. I am representing the electric polarization in terms of polarizability alpha equal to 4 pi epsilon naught into R cube into capital E. What is R here? R is the radius of the atom. E naught is the permittivity of the free space. Okay. Thank you. This is my lecture.